Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV with another Photoshop quick tip. For version CC 2018 and later, there's a feature that smooths out your brush, pencil, and eraser strokes. It's called stroke smoothing. For this example, I'll use the pencil tool. We can adjust the amount of smoothing by changing the percentage amounts. There are many ways to do this. We can use the slider, or click and drag left or right over the word smoothing, or use keyboard shortcuts by pressing and holding Alt or Option as we tap numerical numbers. For example, Alt or Option plus the number 9 equals 90%. Alt or Option plus the number 8 equals 80%, and so on. For 100%, press Alt or Option plus 0, and for 0%, press Alt or Option as you tap 0 twice. When we disable the smoothing feature, we can see that our strokes are rather jittery. However, when we enable the feature, it essentially smooths out our strokes by dragging them taut behind a string or leash. I'll undo the last two strokes by pressing Ctrl or Command Z twice. Click the gear icon in the options bar to see the four smoothing options. By default, Stroke Catch-Up and Adjust for Zoom are both enabled. Adjust for Zoom increases smoothing when you zoom in and decreases smoothing when you zoom out. This helps you make your strokes consistent when you zoom out or in. With Stroke Catch-Up enabled, when you paint and then pause, the stroke will catch up to the current position of your cursor. When you disable it, make a stroke, and then pause, the stroke pauses as well. As soon as you release your cursor, the stroke remains exactly where it is. It's not going to catch up to your cursor's end point. With catch up on stroke end enabled, after you make a stroke, pause your cursor and release it, it'll draw a straight line between where you paused and where the current location of your cursor is. When you enable the pulled string mode, tapping your pen and dragging it displays a circle with a string or a leash emanating from its center. When you pull the string, it becomes taut at the circle's edge. As soon as you drag the tool outside the circle, it begins the stroke in the direction you're pulling it. Using this option allows you to make precise changes in the direction, like sharp corners. If you want to change the color of the string or leash, go to Edit, Preferences, and Cursors. Click the Brush Leash Color to change its color. If you don't want to see the string or leash at all when you make your strokes, uncheck Show Brush Leash while smoothing. This has been a Photoshop quick tip from Marty at Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching!